Welcome to Yoga with me, Dee. Today I'm going to take you through a simple chair yoga practice. It's going to take about 30 minutes where we'll move through just some joint movements and stretches throughout the whole body. For those of you that may be less mobile or stuck at home, or even you can do this from the comfort of your own chair as you watch TV, just some simple movements. So today we're going to need a chair. Sturdy hard chair, yoga block. If you don't have a yoga block, you can just use like a big book if you have a dictionary or something like this at home. And we're also going to use a yoga strap. If you don't have a yoga strap, you can just use a normal belt or the strap off your dressing gown or something like this. So feel free to pause the video, go and get what you need, and we can get started. Chair, feet hip distance apart, flat on the mat, the ankles are coming directly down under the knees. We're sitting up nice and tall. You can bring your hands to your knees. You can come to close your eyes and just bring your awareness to your breath as you begin to inhale and exhale. Through the nose, that feels comfortable for you today. So just noticing your breath. Noticing how your stomach rises as you inhale. Falls as we exhale. Just be here now with a focus on the breath. Forgetting anything that has or hasn't happened. Inhale, we're going to lengthen the spine, come to roll the shoulders up, back and down a few times. We're going to change direction, up, forward and down. We're just going to start at the feet and work our way up. So you can come onto your heels. As we inhale, we're going to squeeze the toes and exhale to release. Start with some ankle rotations, so just moving the feet around in a circular motion. Change direction. As we come back to center, point the toes, pulling back towards you. And release the feet back down towards the mat. We take a breath here. To the knees, we're going to inhale to stretch the leg out in front and exhale to lower it down. you're finding this difficult, you can wrap the strap around the sole of your foot. You're going to inhale to just raise it up, exhale to lower it down. Just slow and steady movements with the breath. Opposite side. Again, we're inhaling to raise the leg and exhaling to lower down. So making sure you're keeping your spine straight and long. You're sitting up from the back of the chair. Bring the hands to the knees, take a deep inhale, and exhale here. We're going to come to grab the back of the knee. Again, if this is difficult for you, you can wrap the strap around the back of the knee, use the strap. We're just going to lift the knee in towards the chest, and exhale to lower down. Side. Inhale to pull it in towards the chest and exhale to lower. We're going to bring the arms out in front. We're going to inhale to squeeze a fist, exhale to release. Change direction. Again, all my cues today are just suggestions. If anything doesn't feel good for you, then please, please don't do it. First listen to your body, and then listen to me. We're going to stretch the arms out in front, palms facing up, inhaling to touch the shoulders, exhaling to release. Our arms come out in front. We're going to get the palms face each other. We're going to inhale to open the arms, squeeze the shoulder blades, open the chest. Exhaling to come back to center. Next time we come back to center, our fingertips come to the shoulders, elbows in front. We're going to inhale to raise the elbows up, Exhale to roll the shoulder blades back and down. And change direction, inhaling up, exhaling forward and down. As you release the hands, you can shake the shoulders out. We're just going to take three deep inhales through the nose and exhales through the mouth to release any tension you may be holding in the shoulders of the neck. As we inhale, you're squeezing the shoulders up to the ears, exhaling to let them drop and exhaling through the mouth. Again. One last time. To the neck, you raise your right arm, place it gently over the left ear, so making sure the shoulders remain relaxed and away from the ears. Your spine is straight and long, core is tight, feet are hip distance apart, flat on your mat. Just going to hold it here for a couple of breaths. You can reach that left arm out to the side, wiggle the fingers. Slowly lower that left arm down towards the side of the chair. Just tuning into that left side of the neck. See if you notice any changes in the stretch as your arm lowers down. As it comes down by your side, you can gently creep the arm forward, just up to shoulder level, and exhaling back down. Bring it up slightly behind. And back to center. Taking one last deep inhale. And exhale here. And release. As we come to do the same at the opposite side, we're reaching that left arm overhead and just placing it gently over the right ear. Gently pulling that head towards the left. We'll take a breath here. To reach that right arm out to the side. Wiggle the fingers, tuning into the right side of the neck as you lower the arm. Noticing if you feel any changes in the stretch in the neck. So your hand comes down by your side, improve it forward, stop to shoulder level. Exhale back down. Slightly behind. And back down to center. Take one last deep inhale. And exhale here. And release. So we're just going to draw the chin into the chest. If you like, you can interlace the fingers and bring them to the back of your head, keeping the shoulders relaxed and away from the ears. Making sure the spine stays straight and long, core is tight. Next inhale, you can release and look forward. As we inhale, we're going to reach the arms up overhead to lengthen. As we exhale, we're going to turn it towards the right side. So we're trying to keep the knees straight in front. If it's easier, you can bring the feet together. We're going to turn around and grab the back of the chair and come to look over that right shoulder if that feels comfortable for you. So we're just having a gentle twist, keeping your focus on the navel, feeling the twist. Inhale, we're going to come back to center. Again, we're reaching the arms up overhead to lengthen. Exhaling to come around to the opposite side. It's comfortable for your neck, looking over that left shoulder. And come back to center. Again, we're reaching the arms up overhead to lengthen. Exhaling to bring them back down towards your knees. And we'll take a breath here. Next, we're going to come into the side stretch. So we're going to use our block or a book or whatever you have available to you here. So you're going to put it down by your right side. So we're sitting up tall, and we're going to come to lean down towards the block. So it's just coming outside of the right hip. We're going to reach the left arm up and over, palms facing down, both sit bones remain on the chair. You can keep looking forward or gently come to look up. So you're breathing deeply into that left rib cage, feeling the ribs expand as you inhale. And fall as you exhale. Inhale to come back up to center. You can place your block at the opposite side. And just bringing the palms down to the back of the chair. You want to push into the palms and lengthen out that spine. And exhale to release. So we're going to come to do the same at the left. So we're gently leaning towards the left side. Bring the palm down towards that left block or hook or whatever you have. And we're reaching the right arm up and over. Again, both sit bones remain firmly on the chair. Palms facing down. You can continue to go forward, or look up, breathing deeply into the right rib cage. Feeling it expand as you inhale, and fall as you exhale. Lengthen out that spine as you inhale and exhale to release. So next we're going to do some cat-cow movements while on the chair. So you're sitting on the edge of the chair. You can bring your hands behind. So as you inhale, you're going to push the belly towards the front and gently go forward or up. Exhaling, we're going to curl the spine, pulling the belly button back towards the spine, drawing the chin to the chest, and bringing the shoulders forward. Inhale, pushing forward, looking up, squeezing the shoulder blades, opening the chest, and exhaling, curling the spine, chin to chest, relaxing the shoulders. inhale and coming back to center. We're going to come to bring our block in front, just down between the legs. So we're sitting nice and tall on our chair. We're going to do 3 deep inhales to reach the arms up, bringing the palms together, exhaling back down. And again. One more time. And on this exhale, we're going to gently come to fold forward. So we're bringing both palms down towards the block. You're going to inhale to lengthen the spine and look forward. And then exhale to fold, dropping the crown of the head towards the mat. And just hold it here for a few breaths. Inhale, you're going to half lift, looking forward. You're going to bring your left palm firmly down onto your block. Now on your next inhale, you're going to reach up and look up towards the right. Very gentle twist. Feel free to keep looking forward. And if it's okay for your neck, looking up towards that right hand. Exhale and come back down. Bring that right palm onto your block. Inhale, reaching up and looking up to the other side if it's comfortable for your head. But continue to look forward or down. Exhale, bring both palms back down towards the mat. We'll take one last deep inhale. And exhale here. And on your next inhale, pushing into the feet, engaging the core, slowly rising back up to center. And come to roll the shoulders up back and down. We're going to come to stand on our mat. We're going to stand next to the chair. So we're going to come into standing pose. So you can use the chair as support. We're just going to come into our mounting pose. So we're bringing the toes together, heels slightly apart, legs are active, knees are soft, core is tight, rolling the shoulders up back and down. You can keep holding onto the chair here. And just standing as tall as you can. Keeping the chair slightly tucked, gazing front. Or you can come to gently close your eyes. We're going to come to kick that right leg out in front. So if you like, you can just bring the heel to the block, stretching the leg out in front. Or if you want to go a little further today, lift the right leg up off the mat. And just hold here for a few breaths. Exhale to slowly lower back down. As we come to do the same at the opposite side, feel free to shake out that right leg if you need to. As we ground the weight down into the right foot, we're going to lift that left foot off of the mat, bringing the knee up to hip level if possible. Again, you can just bring your foot up to your block at any level if this is more comfortable for you today. We're going to find balance here. If your knee is up to your hip and you want to create some resistance, feel free to push down with the palm up with your knee. Exhale to slowly lower back down. We're staying balancing on the right leg. Feel free to reset if you need. I'm going to kick that left leg out in front. So feel free to straighten the leg. Just bring the heel to the block. Or you can raise it up in front. We'll hold it here for a few breaths. Make sure your spine is straight and long. Engaging the core. Engaging the glutes. And exhale to lower back down. Again, you can come shake the legs out if you need. So next we're going to come into a supported forward fold. So you can come to the back of your chair. You can stand about 4 feet back from the chair. We're going to inhale to lengthen. And we're going to exhale to gently come to forward fold. So bringing your palms down to the back of the chair. You're trying to keep the spine straight and long. You can bend your knees here as much as you need. And just coming to fold. Keeping the core engaged, spine as straight as possible. Feet are hip distance apart. Into the back of the chair, engaging the core, slowly rising back up to standing. We're going to come to train track the feet. So by this, I mean you're bringing one foot in front, one foot behind. They stay hip distance apart. Both feet are pointing towards the chair. Again, we're going to inhale to lengthen, and exhale to gently come to forward fold. And you can bend the knees here as much as you need. And down towards the back of the chair. Working with the breath, inhaling to lengthen, exhaling to fold. Inhaling to come back up to center. You're going to come to swap the legs and do the same with the opposite side. So you're bringing the other leg in front again, your hip distance apart. Inhaling to lengthen. Exhaling to gently come to fold forward. Bending the knees as much as we need. And slowly lower us back up to center. And bring both feet a distance apart. We're going to come back, sit on our chair. So we're going to open the legs, toes are pointing out. Inhaling, lengthening the spine. We're going to inhale to reach the arms up and lengthen. Exhale to bring them down. Bring them towards the front of the chair. And gently come to fold forward. Inhaling back up to center. You can come to bring both hands onto the right knee. Twisting towards the left, keeping the spine straight down. Okay, as we come back to center, bringing our legs back into center. Again, we're going to use our strap one last time. We're going to come to wrap around the soles of the feet. We're going to come to kick the feet out in front, keeping the spine straight and long. We're going to grab the edges of the strap, opening the feet out to the sides. Bending the knees, gently come to cross the right ankle over the left knee. If this is difficult for you, you can straighten that left leg to make it a little lower. Just gently butterfly the knees out to the side. Do the same with the opposite leg, crossing the left ankle over the right knee, gently butterflying the knee, and stretch that right leg out in front. You need to come down a bit lower. The mat, bring your hands to your knees, palms facing up. If you want your legs to be elevated, feel free to pop them up on your book, stretching them out in front. As you come to close your eyes, just let your breath come back to its natural rhythm. Noticing how your stomach rises as you inhale and falls as you exhale. Taking a moment to scan your body and feel the benefits of your practice. And to thank yourself for taking the time to practice today. On our next inhale, we're going to reach the arms up overhead to lengthen, bringing the palms together. Exhaling back down to heart center.